Mary Francis says that she's surprised that the report on the probe into the alleged extrajudicial killings by the Royal St. Lucia Police Force has apparently not yet been presented. Ms. Francis says that the information she has received is that the report would be submitted by mid-May this year. The human rights activist and attorney at law has called for the release of the report in an effort to put some sort of closure to the matter and to allow the minds of the families affected to rest.
The information I have is that the report should have been in by the middle of May. So whether it is there and the government is sitting on it, I cannot tell. But I'm saying is something should be said as to whether in fact they have received. What is wrong in the government making it known that yes, the report has been delivered to the government of St. Lucia, and then they are studying it, or let us know something. I think it's time that we hear something on the matter.
A team of police investigators from Jamaica has been conducting an independent probe into 12 alleged extrajudicial killings by members of the Royal St. Lucia Police Force dating back to 2010, during which period there were claims that local officers had a hit list of criminals who were being targeted.
There's a new trade winds exercise being carried on today in one of the OECS territories, and St. Lucia is not represented. So again, it is important to remember the consequences of police not doing things within the law, or when they act and persons die as a result of their actions. You must follow the proper procedure, and there must be accountability. And if the police are found wanting, they must be prosecuted like every other citizen.
The United States had used the police lanes, five of which occurred in a single incident, to cut back on aid to St. Lucia Police, and the government here had said that assistance from Washington would remain suspended pending the results of the inquiry. Mary Francis says that some closure must be brought to the matter, and the lack of accountability which took place under Operation Restore Confidence, which she says now has a backlash against the police.
The processes which the law provides must be followed, and I hope that this has really set an example and we can move on when we get the report, who is supposed to be paid, or if persons are supposed to be sanctioned for the part that they played. Let it happen and put the recommendations in place to ensure that the police force, that will never happen again.
The Prime Minister has said that the report of the investigation into allegations of extrajudicial killings by the police will eventually be made public. Reporting for the TBS News World, I am Cecile Actille.